Hi guys, I'm Chef Avi and in this episode of Avi's Kitchen, I'll be showing you how to make hot chocolate bombs. If you don't know what a hot chocolate bomb is, it's really trendy right now. It's basically two chocolate shells filled with hot chocolate mix and marshmallows. Awesome. I temper my own chocolate. The way I do is this, I just use a really good quality chocolate bar like this one. And I heat it at really low heat over a double boiler, and I keep an eye on the heat of the chocolate. I would not let it go above 90 to 91 degrees Fahrenheit. I use my infrared thermometer for that. That way the chocolate stays in temper and I don't have to do the whole tempering process. It melts really gently but stays in temper. So that's what I did today. But if you don't have an infrared thermometer and you don't want to do the tempering, it's a hassle for you, the chocolate is not your thing, you can just use a compound chocolate which you do not need to temper. It wouldn't taste as good, but that would still do the job. And this is how we make it. Here's my melted chocolate which is still in temper. So using a pastry brush, I'm going to apply an even layer of chocolate in my silicone hemisphere mold. I'm using a silicone mold, you can also use polycarbonate. If you don't have hemisphere mold, you can use any shape you like. Here's a close-up. Once I have covered all the cavities in my mold, I will give my mold a good tap. Then I'll flip my mold over parchment paper. That way the chocolate doesn't settle at the bottom of the hemisphere and the bottom doesn't get too thick. Then I'm gonna flip it again and set it aside until the chocolate crystallizes. Shells look nice, but they're really fragile at the moment, so I'm gonna give it another coating, focusing at the edges more because that seems to be the most fragile part. And I'm gonna cover each and every cavity with the second coat and let it crystallize. The chocolate is set. Now it's time to take it out of the mold. Because I'm using silicone mold, it comes out really easily, just like this. Look how shiny it is. There are two tips to keep in mind while making your domes. One is to make sure that you temper your chocolate well if you're using real chocolate, because if you don't, they might not even come out of the mold. And second is to clean your mold with alcohol and cotton swab, which I did but did not show on video. That way you're gonna achieve shiny hemispheres, just like this. And now this is my favorite hot chocolate mix that I make on my own. I have already posted a video showing how I make this mix. I'll leave a link in the description box below. I'm gonna add in 1 tablespoon of my homemade hot chocolate mix and half of the hemispheres, just like this. This stuff is gold. I always have this in my pantry during winter months. Next up, add in heaps of marshmallows, because what is hot chocolate without marshmallows? You can really customize the bomb with the toppings. You can add peppermint candy, pretzels, whatever you like. Now to seal it, I'm gonna take one hemisphere, place it on a hot pan to melt the edges and make it even, and then quickly place it on my other half, the one with the hot chocolate mix and the toppings. That way it's gonna stick together. I should have worn gloves for this part because I can see my fingerprints in some of the hemispheres, but that's all right. There is a seam where both the hemisphere meet. You can leave it as it is, but I'm gonna add in some more tempered melted chocolate over the seam to hide it. You can also leave it at this point, or you can be extra like me and dip it in your favorite toppings. I'm using chopped hazelnuts today, but you can do cereal, even sprinkles, whatever your heart desires. Set them aside, let them cool, and it's ready. Now for the fun part, let's make our hot chocolate. In your favorite mug, add in 2 hot chocolate bombs, and then slowly add in 1 cup of hot milk. Do it slowly and enjoy the process. I love how the marshmallows just come to the top. This is so amazing. Let it sit for a few seconds and then mix it all together. It's that simple. I'm also loving the cup cozy that my best friend made for me and sent it as my Christmas present from Canada. Thank you, Sundas. Hot chocolate is ready.
I have been sipping my hot chocolate throughout this video. It's so comforting. It's like Christmas in a cup. I love the hot chocolate mix that I make at home, the mini marshmallows, and because we coated our hot chocolate bombs with hazelnut, this tastes like with chocolate with hazelnut, which is an excellent combination in my books. Hello, Ferrero Rocher. So good. If you make this video, which I really, really, really hope you do, do let me know on Instagram @Avi's Kitchen. Until then, like this video and subscribe to my channel. Bye-bye.